In this video, I'm going to share three different ways that you can upload data into Notion from either Excel or Google Sheets. To start off, we're going to do an import of a CSV. Here's the data that we're going to be uploading. And in both Google Sheets and Excel, you have the option to go ahead and download it as a CSV. So we're going to come here to download. Then we're going to get comma separated values. Click on it. Then you should have that data downloaded onto your computer. Next, we're going to go back to Notion. And then we're going to select import on a new page. Once you select import, you'll come to this page where you can choose how you want to import data. And we're going to choose CSV. Select that. And then here is my contact upload from that CSV. So I'm going to select that and then select open. Then there you go. We have that data within Notion and it's taken the name of whatever that CSV document's name was. You can see that it's also pulled in some of the columns here and it's not very great at always consistently guessing what type of property this is. So for me, the status should actually be a status property. So you might just need to go in there and make some adjustments, but a lot of times this is better than going through the alternative of having to enter all the data manually yourself. So the way that you can adjust the type is simply just coming here when you're editing the property, and then we would go down to select status, and there you go, it's been converted into a status. Now let's say that you want to import some data into an already existing Notion database. So the first step that you're going to want to make sure you take is that all of the columns for whatever data you're uploading line up with what you have in your Notion database. If you don't do this, then Notion is automatically going to create new properties and it's not going to merge the data correctly. So it's very crucial that you name your columns of your CSV sheets the exact same of what you have in Notion. So we're going to take a new contact here and then we're going to upload it into that database we created with that first upload. So I'm going to go here and we are going to download the CSV again. Now that we have downloaded that CSV, we're going to come up here to the top right and then we're going to select merge with CSV. Then you're going to select whatever data you want to be imported into this existing database, open it, and then there you go, we have that new contact added to our contact database. If you're working with small amounts of data, a faster way to do this without going through the process of uploading a CSV is to simply copy and paste your Excel or Google Sheet data into Notion. So let's go back to our Google Sheet, and then we're just going to simply copy this here, and then we're going to paste it into Notion, and then it's going to paste it like this. You're going to want to click, and then you're going to turn it into a database. So you can see sometimes it's a little weird with the upload. For this first record here, it actually took the column names, it put them here, and then just gave some generic column names. So I'm just going to go in here and quickly change them. Now that I've changed the column names, we're just going to delete this record, and let's hide this database title. But let's say that you want to just drag and drop a few records into existing Notion database, then you can do that as well. So we're going to go to our second upload and we're going to copy this. And below on this page, we're going to paste. Once again, we're going to turn it into a database. And then after you've made it so that these databases match in terms of the titles of the columns, then you can simply just click on the record and then drag and drop into this other database and it'll pull over that information. And then you can come in here and delete this database, and then you're good to go. So that's it for the tutorial on how to upload some data from Google Sheets and Excel. Let me know in the comments below if you guys have any questions while you're uploading data into Notion. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more Notion tutorials like this in the future. See you next time.